In the name of the
In the
Father,
name
of
of
the
the
Son,
Father,
of the
of the
Holy
Son, of
Spirit.
the Holy
Amen.
Spirit. Amen. Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful and enkindle in them the fire of your love. Send forth your Spirit, and they shall be created, and you shall renew the face of the earth. O God, who by the light of the Holy Spirit instructs the hearts of the faithful, grant us with the same Holy Spirit to be truly wise and always to rejoice in His consolation through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. From the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew.
Glory to you,
Glory
O
to you, O Lord.
Herod the Tetrarch heard of the reputation of Jesus and said to his servants, "This man is John the Baptist. He has been raised from the dead. That is why mighty powers are at work in him." Now Herod had arrested John, bound him, and put him in prison on account of Herodias, the wife of his brother Philip. For John said to him, "It is not lawful for you to have her." Although he wanted to kill him, he feared the people, for they regarded him as a prophet. But at a birthday celebration for Herod, the daughter of Herodias performed a dance before the guests and delighted Herod so much that he swore to give her whatever she might ask for. Prompted by her mother, she said, "Give me here on the platter the head of John the Baptist." The king was distressed, but because of his oaths and the guests who were present, he ordered that it be given, and he had John beheaded in the prison. His head was brought in on a platter and given to the girl, who took it to her mother. His disciples came and took away the corpse and buried him, and they went and told Jesus. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ. Tita Lynn.
Yes, one moment. One moment. Kaya nawawala. Nawala ang copy ko. For today's Gospel. Number one. Herod lacked moral courage to make correct decisions and was afraid of losing face. He was mesmerized with entertainment glitz that made him light-headed and foolish. Number two, do you pray for God's wisdom and courage to make wise, informed choices? Number three, do you start each day by offering yourself and asking for the Holy Spirit's guidance and protection for the rest of the day? Amen.
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 Thank you very much, Tita Lynn. So today's Gospel is about King Herod, about the beheading of John the Baptist. I have read one of the homilies na there are a lot of John the Baptist nowadays. Mga those who fear, those who are proclaiming their faith, but despite the fact that ano ang life nila, no, in danger ng life nila, modern day life natin, no, yung mga Christians, no, in non-Christian countries, and some of them are really cannot denounce their faith ba. So they will suffer persecution. So this homilies, no, has a lot of names, no, na totoo. I mean, modern day John the Baptist, na they cannot just renounce their faith, kaya they were persecuted. So and the case of Herod, no, secretly siguro Herod was admiring John the Baptist, no, kaya lang John the Baptist was bold enough to declare na what he is doing is immoral, kaya nagalit ang Herod, si Herodias. nagalit siya kasi Herodias is the wife of Herod's brother. Oh, kaya you know, revenge. Ang ginawa ni Herodias is revenge kay John the Baptist. Kaya hiningi niya ang ulo ni John the Baptist sa kay King Herod. So it is between moral obligation and the political and popularity obligation. Yun ang naano si Herod dyan. Wala siya magawa. Wala siya magawa. Talagang because he promised Salome, the daughter of Herodias, no, na ask whatever you want, I will give it to you. Pero ang gina-ask naman is ulo ni John Baptist na I think King Herod was not very happy about that, not very happy, but he already made a promise, he will stand to his promise despite the fact na immoral ang ginawa niya. So just like us, we sometimes we are caught, no, in between decisions, no, whether moral, either moral, no, or something na against our will, no, or yung go with the tide na lang, yun ang sabi ba, kung ano na lang ang sabihin ng mga tao, yun ang pinakapopular, dyan ka na lang. Pero deep inside mo is ayaw mo sana. So yun, may mga moments in life tayo na parang si King Herod tayo. We have to decide. And then may mga moments in life din tayo na we are John the Baptist. That we will really stand to the morals, to the values, Christian values. Amen.
Amen.
Tito Mans.
Okay. Marino das Marinas. Who is King Herod? King Herod is a tyrant, a leader who will never think twice to suppress or neutralize anyone who dares cross his path. He will not only suppress, Herod could even order the killing of anyone he wants so that he could remain in power. Respect for human rights is not part of the vocabulary of Herod. Abuse of human rights and dignity are. This is the reason why John the Baptist was imprisoned. John did nothing wrong. He simply said that what was to be truthfully said, yet John suffered for it. Many leaders are like King Herod. They would bully themselves by the use of strong words and autocratic power to achieve what they want. We should be very careful and watch of these kinds of leaders, for they will not do us any good. They will only use and manipulate us and bring us to perdition. Many Herods are roaming around in this world today. We therefore have to be watchful and careful so that we can immediately distance ourselves from them. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Well, Herod was, he wants to, just like politicians today, no? They want to
good
stay
example.
In power.
Oh, good example.
Do anything, violate anything, just to stay in power. Kasi iba nga naman eh, no? Pag nasa power ka. Yun ang kay Herod na type of might say politician, kung politician siya, no? He wants to be a king maybe forever. Kaya he made a mistake though, no? He made a promise, an oath. So he will be in a very awkward situation if he breaks that oath, that promise. But he broke it because he wanted to stay in power. Ayaw niyang mapahiya sa mga bisita.
Mga dignitaries ang bisita niya.
Because he promised. Kahiyaan na to eh, sabi niya eh. So we had John beheaded. And, he respected John because he knows he was a prophet. No? He feared John. In fact, he listens to the teaching or preaching of John. But he cannot compromise with that, with the with his desire to stay in power. That's why he is being compared to our politicians and politics of today, modern politics. No? They'll use everything, power, money, even kill goons, no? Even to kill the those who opposed them. So we see that there's not much different today and before the time of Jesus. But John the Baptist stood for the truth. See, he did not want to compromise the truth. He suffered that. He did not die because of his faith, but he died because of an uncompromising stand for the truth. Kasi alam niya yung totoo. No? And today, the question is, can we do the same? What John did, or baka when faced with danger, we will compromise in order to save our skin, or you know, money, power of money. Baka mag-ibang isip tayo pag nabigyan na yung mga ibang pagmahina ang yung paninindigan, no? Masisilaw ka sa pera. Mag-iiba ang yung pananaw, yung decision. Just like what Herod did. Amen.
Amen. Thank you. Oh, thank you very much, Tito Manny. It's very true, no? And the best example, really, ang mga politicians na ito ba? Mga leaders of the nation, mga top positions siguro sa mga corporate na example, like you declare yourself a Catholic and you are okay with abortion. Mga ganyan ba? So, very good example talagang politicians. It's between the moral and Christian values or the will of the people. Not the will of the people, but the will of the many. So, in order to keep your position, you have to go with the people instead of moral and Christian values. So very, very deceiving. So that's what happened to King Herod, no? And then may isa naman na from Haro Cathedral ba, the focus of the gospel is never be the reason of one's downfall. Yun. Never be the reason of one's downfall. That's what happened to Herodias ba? Ang ano ni Herodias? Na hiningi niya ang ulo ni John the Baptist to take revenge. Kasi nga ayaw niya sa mga sinasabi ni John the Baptist na immoral ang relationship ninyo kasi you married brother ang wife siya ni Philip and then she married the brother-in-law na si King Herod. Kaya never be the reason for one's downfall. Huwag mo naman siraan ang ibang tao. Modern time natin is mga chismis, mga fake news, downfall, para mag-downfall, para sa, to the extent na it will cause downfall of other people ba. So, maraming lessons tayo for today's gospel. Marami tayong lessons. So, Tita Helen, do you have something?
Yes, Tita.
Pwede pa isa. Oh. Sige. No, please go ahead.
Titled, He Had John Beheaded. There are times when out of excitement, we could be wrong in what we say and do. It would be worse when, after realizing the wrongness of the word we are about to say or the action we are about to do, we would still say or do. Today's gospel tells of the beheading of John the Baptist. John was put in prison by Herod on account of his denunciation of Herod's affair with Herodias. During Herod's birthday, the daughter of Herodias dances. Herod is so delighted that he swears to give the girl whatever she asked for. Prompted by Herodias, the girl asked for the head of John the Baptist. Herod could have recounted his previous pronouncement, but he does not. He has John beheaded. When we are tempted to hurriedly say or do something, let us first take a pause and think of the implications of what we are about to say or do. Prior to doing or saying anything, do we first take a pause? Do we practice discernment? Do we retract from saying or doing something which we realize to be wrong? Amen.
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 Thank you very much, Sita Helen. So yun, those are the lessons we learned from today's gospel, no, about King Herod, the beheading of John the Baptist, the revenge of Herodias. So lessons in life natin yan. You have to stand what is Christian and moral value, even if it will hurt us or will be persecuted or will be put to death. We will stand just like John the Baptist. We stand by the word of God. Amen.
Amen.
Miga Belen for the closing prayer.
Closing, yes. Heavenly Father, we are so grateful for the guidance in our lives. Please help us always remember to pray and honor you. Allow us to grow closer as a prayer group. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And all together, please. Glory be to the Father, to the Son, to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you. Thank you all. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I love you guys.